Hi friends, now we are going to see the next unit in history, unit 6, the Middle Ages. In the previous unit, we discussed about the classical world, about the Greek and the Rome people. Now here, about the Middle Ages. Learning objectives. To learn about the empires of China during the reign of Tang, Song and Yuan dynasties. To understand the evolution of Japanese society under the Fujiwara family and Kamakura Shogunate. To trace the background of the birth of Islam. To acquire knowledge of Arab and Ottoman empires and their contribution to the spread of Islamic culture. To analyze the characteristics of feudalism in the Middle Ages. To understand the relationship between the state and the church in the Middle Ages. First thing is introduction. Let we all know that what happened in the Middle Ages. Historians call the period between the end of the Roman Empire in 476 AD, that is in Common Era, and the capture of Constantinople by the Turks. Constantinople, now at present, it's Istanbul in Turkey, by the Turks in 1453 AD as the Middle Ages. The Middle Ages has been further classified as early, central or high and later. Classified as early, central or high and later. In the early Middle Ages, approximately 5th to 10th century, Christianity followed by Islam. After 10th century, Christianity followed by Islam began to establish themselves as a dominant religion of continental Europe. The central or high Middle Ages witnessed rapid development marked by the territorial expansion, demographic and urban growth, and the restructuring of secular and ecclesiastical institutions. What is that ecclesiastical? Priestly, or relating to the Christian church or its clergy. So here, the history of Arab civilization that began a little later than the history of Byzantium, which covers a period roughly from 630 AD to 1300, known as Saracenic civilization. It was the center of a new religion, and its impact on Christian Europe was responsible for revolutionary social and intellectual changes. Byzantium, that is an ancient city on the Bosporus founded by the Greeks, a site of modern Istanbul. Byzantine, as we have already learned, are complicated and difficult to understand the emperors. So Byzantine. Now Seljuk Turks. Seljuk, its origin starts from a member of any of the pre-Ottoman Turkish dynasties ruling over large parts of Asia in the 11th, 12th and 13th century AD. Seljuk Turks, they were a tribe of Tatars, that is Hun, that is a German soldier from the Central Asia. They established a powerful empire in Persia. Their reign was one of the great progress in literature, art and architecture. Similarly, the Ottoman Turks who moved Anatolia, that is Asia Minor, and established an independent empire contributed to science and technology in a big way. East Asia in the Middle Ages. Under that, we are going to discuss about the China. There are three dynasties like Tang dynasty, Song dynasty, Yuan dynasty. Under that, number one is Tang dynasty. Sui dynasty collapsed in 40 years because of financial burden imposed by the public works like the Grand Canal and the expensive wars waged to conquer the northern part of Korea. To capture the part of Korea, they were taken a war. So it was too much of expensive to them. So the Tang dynasty rose from the widespread rebellions that took place to establish a strong centralized empire. Li Yuan, who organized the rebellion, made that Yang Yu the emperor of China. As Yang was killed by one of his royal officials, the chancellor, Li Yuan proclaimed himself as an emperor. He himself turned as a emperor. Several hundred kilometers of Great Wall were rebuilt along the northwest frontiers. Military campaigns extended the empire's influence into Korea in the east and as far as the borders of Persia and Indochina in the west. Now look at, you know very well about the Great Wall of China. This is between 8th and 7th centuries BC. Before Common Era, the warring states in China built defensive walls to protect themselves from enemies from the north. During Qin, that is Qin dynasty, the separate walls were connected and consequently the wall stretched from the east to west for about 5000 kilometers. This wall, considered to be one of the wonders of the world, served to keep nomadic tribes out. So the wall was further extended and strengthened by the succeeding dynasties. Now it is around 6700 kilometers in length. Now look at the Song dynasty, 960 to 1279 AD, that is in Common Era. The rebellion of hard-pressed peasants under the leadership of Hung Chaos dealt death knell to the tottering Tang Empire, that is shivering, not in a proper level, that empire. The empire split into five rival states until it was reunited under a new dynasty, Song. Trade and industry flourished during the reign of Song dynasty. Iron and steel industry became highly organized. Now look at the quantity of iron China produced in 1078 AD, which exceeded 114,000 tons. England produced only 68,000 tons, even in 1788. So China excelled in ceramics and porcelain making. Ceramics means pottery works, which is made up of clay and permanently hardened by the heat. So these are the types. And porcelain making, it's a white vitrified translucent ceramic in China, which was made in China. So porcelain making. This technique was not known to Europe for another 700 years. Gunpowder was in use by 1044. So that is also invented by China. China possessed printed books half a millennium before Europe. So it is a people's history of the world. Now look at the fall of Song dynasty. Song period was also a period of great prosperity to the landowning class, officials and rich merchants. The peasants, the farmers, by contrast, had to suffer grinding poverty. Before any internal crisis could develop, there were two external invasions from the north that ended the Song dynasty. Now, the Mongols, they established their rule in the name of Yuan dynasty. Who established their rule in the Yuan dynasty? Mongols. Mongols established their rule in the name of Yuan dynasty. Yuan dynasty, it begins 1279 to 1368 AD. The Mongols, who overran Persia and the whole of Central Asia, did not spare the China either. Mangu Khan became the great Khan in 1252, who appointed the Kublai Khan the governor of China. The Mongol presence from one end to Eurasia, the other played a key role in spreading Chinese technological advances to the less developed society in the West. So though the Mongol court in Beijing, which impressed a foreigner like Marco Polo, the poverty of peasantry continued. There were revolts of religious sects and secret societies. Finally, the leader of the Red Turbans, the Chu Yuan Chang, who captured the Mongol capital, Beijing, and proclaimed himself emperor in 1369. Look at that Kublai Khan, and this is a Mongol court, Ming Empire. So it is the empire which replaced the Mongol Empire consciously discouraged industry and foreign trade in order to concentrate on agriculture. So this resulted economically China lagging behind in the 16th century. Other parts of Eurasia, building on the techniques of the Chinese, began to march ahead. Now Japan. Many of the ancestors of the Japanese came from Korea and some from the Malaysia. It was through the Korea the Chinese civilization reached Yamato. Yamato was the original name of Japan. So the original inhabitants of the country, that is known as Ainos. The original religion of Japan was Shinto. It was a mixture of nature and ancestor worship. Japan remained in isolation for many centuries. This gave them the benefit of enjoying freedom from the foreign invasions. In Japan, Buddhism came through Korea. This is a Shinto religion, what they followed by the Japan. In Japan, also the leading families opposed and fought each other to gain power. Their emperor, Mikado, was an autocrat, but a puppet in the hands of a few powerful families. The first great family that controlled the state was the Soga family. Shotoku Taishi was a leader. He made the central government strong. But after the death of Shotoku Taishi, his family was driven out by the Nakatomi no Kamatari, the founder of the Fujiwara family. Kamatari adopted many Chinese methods and made the central government further strong. So he made Nara the capital. From 794 AD, Kyoto remained the capital for more than 1000 years until it was replaced by Tokyo. Now you know very well Japan's capital is Tokyo. So Fujiwara family emperors in later years retired to monasteries and lived as monks. Yet they continued to exercise authority. Now we are going to discuss about the Islam and the rise of Islamic empires. You know, whenever we are talking about the Islam, who established the Islam? Prophet Muhammad established Islam. Islam gave a message of brotherhood. Muhammad laid stress on the equality of all those who were Muslims. This message of equality and brotherhood had great appeal not only for the Arabs, who were divided into warring tribes, but also for people in other parts of the world. However, faced the persecution in his place of birth, Muhammad and his followers moved to the city of Yathrib. That is, the flight of Muhammad from Mecca in 622 AD is called as a Hijra in Arabic. In honor of his coming, the people of Yathrib renamed the city to Madinatul Nabi, the city of the Prophet. It is now known as Medina. Muhammad died 10 years after the Hijrat in 632 AD. By the time of his death, united under a common faith, the Arabs became a powerful force. Now look at this Mecca. Arabian. Abu Bakr and Umar, who succeeded the Prophet Muhammad as a caliph, that is successor, both in a religious and temporal leader, laid the foundation for an Islamic empire. In a short period of time, the Arabs defeated both the Eastern Roman Empire and the Sassanid King of Persia. Jerusalem, the holy city of Jews and Christians, was won by the Arabs, and the whole of Spain and Persia came under the new Arab Empire, to whom we called as the Jews, a member of a people whose traditional religious is Judaism. They were called as a Jews. Islam advocated simplicity and equality. These two ideas impressed the people fed up with the old order of oppression and exploitation. The Arabs easily overran many regions. Egyptians had suffered much under the Roman Empire, and so they opted for Arabs. Led by the general Tariq, the Arabs, after conquering Morocco and Africa, crossed into Europe and took Spain, which they ruled for many hundreds of years. The Arabs, until then largely nomads from the deserts, they became the rulers of a mighty empire. So they were called as the Saracens from Sahara and Nashin, the dwellers of the desert. The birth of the Sunni and Shia Muslims, sects, the divisions. The quarrel for the leadership of Arabia led to a division in Islam. The two sects formed out of the division were the Sunnis and the Shias. The Sunnites, Sunni Muslims, maintained that the head of the Islamic State and successor to the prophet should be elected by representatives of the whole body of believers. The Shiites, the followers of Shia, oppose the elevation to any highest political and religious office other than those related to the prophet by blood or by marriage. So this is the birth of Sunni and the Shia sects difference. Rule of Umayyad dynasty. Umayyad or Umayyad. The caliphs, that is the successor, those who belong to a branch of Muhammad's family known as the Umayyads. Or the Umayyads ruled for about 100 years. Damascus was their capital. So they developed a new style of architecture known as Saracenic architecture. The arches, the pillars and the minarets and domes came to India later and blended with the Indian ideas. Look at this picture. This is the Saracenic architecture. They followed. Then the Muslim Arabs carried the Islam far and wide. But while they were fighting at distant lands, the Arabs at home were quarreling. Ali, the son-in-law of Prophet Muhammad, and his son Hussein were murdered. Umayyads were overthrown by Abbasids. Who were the Abbasids? The Prophet Muhammad's uncle, name was Abbas, and his followers were called as the Abbasids. The rule of Abbasids. Abbasid rule began in 750 AD, assuming the title of the commander of the faithful. Just make a note, what was the title? They assumed commander of the faithful. Abbasid caliph wielded authority as any other emperor. So, the Abbasids tried to rival the old empires in splendor. The capital was shifted from Damascus to Baghdad in Iraq. Now that we are going to see about the importance of the Baghdad. Baghdad, a city known as the City of Arabian Nights. What is called? It is the City of Arabian Nights. It was a vast city of palaces and public offices and schools and colleges and great shops and parks and gardens are available. So the merchants who carried on a vast trade with the East and West, visitors came to Baghdad from all over the world, especially learned men and students and artist Nehru. Glimpses of world history. Now look at that. Crusades and fall of Seljuk Turks. It's one of your first detailed answer. The Pope and the Church called upon all the Christian peoples of Europe to march to the rescue of the holy city, Jerusalem. This is the city of Jerusalem. So here the Crusaders had to fight against the Seljuk Turks who controlled those parts. The struggle between the Christianity and Islam beginning in 1095, who continued for nearly 200 years and is called the Crusades. Crusaders, the fight between the Christian people and the Islamic people, they started to fight against that to get back the Jerusalem. So they were under the Crusades. The Crusades did not achieve the desired end. So Jerusalem continued to remain in Ottoman hands for another 700 years. This continuous fighting associated with the Crusades weakened the Seljuk Turks. The Mongol invasion from the east sidelined this cause, and Christians and Muslims alike started shifting their attention towards advancing Mongols led by Genghis Khan. So, the destruction of Baghdad in 1258 AD by the Mongols, which put an end to what remained of the Abbasid Empire. Now, this is the impact of Crusades. This is Jerusalem. The Muslims and the Christian peoples are fighting to get back the place. Impact of the Crusades. Crusades ended the feudal relations. So many of the nobles who went to East to take part in the Crusades either stayed too long a period or did not return. So the serfs, that is the peasants people, the farmers or the poor people, slaves we call, they took advantage of their absence to break away from their bondage to the soil. So increasing the demand for the products of the East led to the expansion of trade. Which are the places they have made a Venice, Genoa and Pisa, which emerged as an important commercial centers in the Mediterranean region. Constantinople, who ceased to be the middleman in the trade between the East and the West. The elimination of powerful nobles had its influence in strengthening the monarchy in France and England. One of the notable outcomes of crusade was the loss of prestige suffered by the Pope and Papacy. Look at the Mongols and the Genghis Khan. Mongols were the nomads, the nomadic, unaware of that. They were the herdsmen, cattle rearing. Then horse makes the herdsmen. The Mongols were experts in warfare and produced a remarkable chief, Genghis Khan. He was a great military genius. Mongols hold over Russia for about 300 years, which made the Russia technologically backward from the rest of Europe until the end of the Middle Ages. Look at this map. This is a map. The Ottoman Empire. Now look at this. We're going to talk about feudalism. Feudalism, it's like a slavery. It is defined as a medieval European political, economic and social system from the 9th century to the 15th century. So under this, the state has been divided here. Despite the hold of powerful religions such as Christianity and Islam, the economic life of the people was governed by the feudal relations. This is the king, number one in the feudal relations. Look at that. Afterward, fief and the peasants, vassals to king. They are the slaves like. Okay, they are staying in the one land. The free peasants like, to whom he paid dues and services in return for a land. So they are the here, loyalty to the lords. Military aid people are waiting. And this is the foot, protections, homage knights, vassals to the lords, shelter provider. Then the peasant serves to protect them. Peasants farm the land, food productions, then paying the rent and the shelter provisions. This is the feudalism. State has been mannered under the king. The king, supposed to represent the god on earth, was at the head of the feudal regime. Immediately after him were the great nobles known as dukes, counts and the earls. The relationship was one of a vassal, that is villeins, a feudal tenant. The nobles in turn had vassals of their own, dividing and distributing their fief to lesser nobles called viscounts or barons. Last in this order were the knights, whose fiefs could not be divided. At the bottom were the villeins or serfs, they are called as the slaves. So everything, it is explanation of this picture. So this is one of your third brief answer you are finding. Lost in this order were that? They were the knights whose fiefs could not be divided. At the bottom were the villeins or serfs, they are called as the slaves. Now finally, we are going to discuss about the church. New elements were included in Christian theology. They were the theory of priesthood and the theory of sacraments. These two elements increased the power of the clergy. Which are the two? Now look at this. Excommunication and interdict. Excommunication meant depriving a person of all the privileges of a Christian. He was denied the right of to the sacraments in church. His or her body could not be buried in the consecrated ground. That is excommunication. It meant depriving a person of all the privileges of Christian. He was denied the right to the sacraments in church. His or her body could not be buried in the consecrated ground. Interdict. It was to deny the benefits of religion to a ruler's subject intended to kindle their resentment against him. Interdict was to deny, to refuse the benefits of the religion to a ruler's subject, which intended to kindle their resentment against him. The growth of the church in the Middle Ages, later Middle Ages, was accompanied by the rise of ambitious political leaders. In the conflict between the German Emperor Henry IV and Pope Gregory VII, Pope by means of interdict succeeded in making the Emperor to abdicate the throne. By means of interdict, Pope Innocent III forced the King John to recognize England and Ireland as the fiefs of the papacy. Many pious Christians now began to resent Pope's intrusion into state affairs. So this is the entire thing about the Christian and as well as the Islam. Then this is the lesson which brought over. Thank you, my dears. Please go through the lesson.